Yo, how's everybody doing? It's the Hawking Regime here, and today I'm coming at you guys with another Madden player creation tutorial here on the Hawking Regime channel. Today we are working on Troy Polamalu, soon to be, for you know, hopefully for Steelers fans, Hall of Fame strong safety Troy Polamalu from the Pittsburgh Steelers. Played in the NFL for roughly 11 years. Now I'm going to read off some quick bits of information for you guys about Polamalu. First of all, he's a two-time Super Bowl champion. Actually went to the Super Bowl three times with the Pittsburgh Steelers from 2003 to 2014, which is when he played in the NFL. Went three times, only won twice against the Seahawks. Still angry about that. And against the Arizona Cardinals, but did lose to the Packers in Super Bowl XLV, I believe. I can't really remember what the exact Roman numerals were. Eight-time Pro Bowler, and he also has a record for most, or tied for most sacks in a game by safety with three. And some of his just career stats as a whole, if you want to know those. 32 career interceptions, 14 forced fumbles, 12 sacks, and a total of 576 tackles. In total of, 100 passes defended. So that's just pretty much some basic stats on Polamalu. I mean, if you're really interested in seeing those in particular things, you know, you can obviously look that up. But also an NFL Defensive Player of the Year in 2010, and I'm pretty sure the Steelers are going to not allow anybody else to use his number or retire his number, because this guy was really quite a legendary player, at least in my personal eyes. Now, I've watched football, you know, for a long time, from roughly the era of the 2000s to like our present day game, from that, you know, roughly area. So I didn't get to watch all the guys in the 90s, the 80s, 70s, 60s, those type of legendary players. When we talk about some of the greatest defensive instincts that you could see in a player in NFL history, Troy Polamalu easily comes to mind for me. And when you talk about best safeties in the league, you know, for the past decade, you know, obviously excluding these past couple of years, Troy Polamalu and Ed Reed were the top safeties in the game. I think that a lot of people could agree on that. You could also put Charles Woodson into that, you know, conversation for sure, except that Charles Woodson also played cornerback. So that's something that a lot of people probably would agree on. And for me, it's super easy, because when you see a guy like Polamalu, the only way I can really, you know, describe him to you is think Earl Thomas and Tyrann Mathieu, but he's a bigger hitter and a bigger bone person. Not quite as fast, but in terms of acceleration and instincts, just as good, if not better, than those guys. So that's really the big comparison I can make about Troy Polamalu. I mean, this guy was so smart. He would time the snap count on NFL quarterbacks and sack them before they even could hand it off to their halfback, play action, whatever. It was insane, some of the plays that you see this guy, that you saw this guy make on Sundays. And I'm sure if anybody's a Pittsburgh Steelers fan out there, you know how great this guy was for the Steelers during his time there. And, you know, this guy, you know, he did have some injury problems late in his career, but played a pretty, you know, lengthy career for a strong safety that hit as hard as he did and that took as much of a hitting as he did. You know, obviously you don't think about the defensive players taking the beating, but, you know, they do over time. So, Polamalu, great player, and I had to create him in Madden because, you know, he wasn't in the game. I don't believe Madden 15 he was in the game, and for sure this past year, Madden 16, he was not in the game. So just trying to create him in Madden. Didn't have a whole bunch of different, you know, pieces of equipment that he wore that made him super unique. His big thing was his hair. You know, a lot of guys didn't have the Samoan long curly hair that he had that sometimes went all the way down to his lower back. It was insane. And that was, you know, you could easily spot him on the football field because of that, and that made him even more appealing to fans, you know, around the, you know, the country and who watch the NFL on it, you know, on a weekly basis. And Polamalu, man, it's just incredible to watch him. So if anybody didn't get to watch him during his, you know, prime, I'm sure pretty much anybody who's watching this video has seen Polamalu either play in real life or in-depth highlights of this guy, because he was unbelievable to watch. As much as it pains me to say it, when he, you know, played against the Seahawks in the Super Bowl, he was, you know, he was young, so I'm not, I don't really remember him being the guy I didn't like. I remember I hated Ben Roethlisberger and Jerome Bettis. Man, those guys were annoying as heck, and they ended up winning the Super Bowl that year against Seattle in a very controversial game, I might add. But this is a Troy Polamalu video. We're not gonna get into this history of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Jumping into the stats here that I added for him, or the attributes, I should say. Basically, this is off the top of my head again. I don't like to just exactly copy what other previous Madden, games had. I did try to make his block shed at least pretty reasonable, because he was, you know, a pretty strong dude, and he, you know, had a tendency to come off of the edge as a pass split, as a blitzer, and was unbelievable at that. That's something that a lot of safeties can't do that Troy Polamalu could do. He'd come off of a corner blitz and just absolutely obliterate the quarterback for a strip fumble that would turn out to be a touchdown or a turnover or whatever. So had to give him that bit of block shed there. You know, the toughness, 99, consistency, confidence, obviously 99. And a big hitter, 95 hit power as well for his only 5'10", 205-pound frame. So, you know, that is Troy Polamalu for you guys. Highly recommend watching highlights of him just to get yourself, you know, understanding of what this guy was and how great of a player he was in the league. But that will be the conclusion of the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. You know, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more Madden NFL 16 content, and in the future, obviously, Madden NFL 17 content as it comes out in a couple months. So that will be the conclusion of the video once again. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. And yeah, thanks for watching.